Setting up your Glide app can be confusing, but mastering the settings and the options in the designer is crucial when it comes to creating a polished and professional looking app. Today, we're going to explore how to navigate and utilize Glide settings to customize your app effectively. Note that this video is part of our complete guide to Glide apps course inside the member area of No Code MBA, and that there's a link in the description. So stick around as Oscar reveals the techniques to optimize your Glide setup. Let's get started.
So once you've signed up, you've got access to your team, you can go ahead and create a new app. So we're going to go and choose a new app, and we're going to call it No Code MBA. And you can then choose how you want to start building. Now, it's important to understand this for this specific reason and also in general. Glide applications are progressive web apps, PWAs for short. What this means is that they are not native applications. They don't enter the app store. You don't get the sort of native source code out the back. They are web applications. That means they exist as URLs. And I guess the best way to put it is, imagine that they are simply super smart websites that look and feel and behave like a native app might do, but they run on a browser or via a URL. So they're totally responsive, which means whether you choose mobile or large, you can, whilst you're building your app, flip between the two. And you'll notice that if you're building it in large, which I recommend, when you view it in mobile, it will size itself perfectly to appear as a mobile application as well. So I recommend large screen, but it's totally up to you. It just gives you a bit more clarity on everything that's going on within your app. So we're going to hit continue, and now we can choose our data source. So Glide gives you a variety of options for a data source. What this essentially means is the database for your app. You can by default access Glide Tables, which is their own data source. You can associate a Google Sheet as your database. You can use Excel and Airtable. And on top of that, you can also now, Glide also now support BigQuery, Google BigQuery, and SQL, which is currently in beta. SQL will allow you to create a Glide app on millions and millions of rows of data, but it's significantly more complex. So we're going to use Glide Tables. I categorically recommend it. It's the fastest, most responsive data source because it's directly within the Glide platform. And also it makes it that little bit easier when designing your app because your database and the app itself are in the same place. So we're going to go ahead and create our new app on Glide Tables. Okay, so what Glide's very cleverly done is put together a basic app for us. And it looks to be a CRM of sort of companies and contacts. And it will do this for you every time, just to give you a little head start. So you can remove everything that's there, or you can work with what you're given. But this is a great place for us to start because I can quickly and easily introduce Glide's sort of core concepts to you guys. So the first thing to understand within the Glide Builder is probably the settings tab. So this is where you determine your top level settings for your app. So how it looks, any sort of integrations, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm going to whiz through these really quickly. Name an icon is where you can essentially provide an icon for your app and decide what you want to call it. You can change this stuff at any time. So let's choose, I like the rocket. Now, it's interesting because when you look at these here, they're emojis. But when you install your Glide app, they actually look really cool, the standard icons that you have access to. But you can also go ahead and upload your own icon. And we're going to keep the name as No Code MBA. So the next view is appearance. So here you can choose the top level appearance of your app. And this, in my opinion, is something that sets Glide above the rest. Because if you're not an expert designer and you don't have experience in things like Figma, then Glide allows you to make your app look beautiful almost just from this appearance setup here. So I'm going to choose a nice blue, and we're going to position the navigation along the top like that. And then you can choose your style. So dark looks really nice, but we're going to go with the accent for this app. And then you can choose your background color. So if you look over here, when I select neutral, it sort of flips which part stands out. I prefer highlight. I think it looks more modern and just gives it a bit of a pop. So that's kind of an overview of the appearance area. Our privacy settings. This is really important if you're looking to build an app that you actually want to publish and have people using, because you can set it up in different ways where it can be private or it can be public. So if we set this app to public, then the sign-in options are going to change. So we can choose a no sign-in app where there's no concept of a user, i.e. 7 billion people could hit this app and it would be absolutely fine and they wouldn't need to sign in or sign up. You can have required sign-in, which means the first screen that anybody sees is the sign-in screen. Or you can have optional, where the user will have the ability at the top right to sign up or sign in if they signed out. And the private option is kind of your more sort of business use case. So you can, when it's set to private, you can ensure that only users in the users table can sign in, or you can choose certain email domains or even just members of your Glide team, which we went through earlier. And they've just released SSO, single sign-on for enterprise. So we won't worry about that now. So we're gonna have this as a private app where users in the users table can sign in. That's sort of the standard route that you would probably take. So integrations, this is where you can connect multiple data sources. So you can actually have an app that has a couple of Google Sheet tables and a couple of Glide tables, and you can mix and match if you wish. And then there's a wide range of integrations that have been introduced, and the little sort of turquoise bubble here indicates the pricing plan that you need to get access to these. Some of these are incredibly powerful. So the next thing to look at is users and authentication. Now, this kind of ties in with the privacy settings, of course, but your users table is going to be a table of choice from your app database. And we're going to go into the database structure next. But what it's actually done is Glide has created a users table and set this up to be the source table for our users. So you don't need to necessarily do anything there. And then you can choose a bunch of additional information. It's important to be aware that sometimes Glide might set this option for you. I really recommend that you collect real user email addresses while you're playing around, because otherwise it's going to be difficult to kind of see which user you're viewing as, etc. And also when you jump into the data, I think while you're testing, it's probably going to be more likely that you actually want to collect the user's email addresses. And finally, cookies. So if you choose to set a user authentication cookie, what that means is when somebody signs into the app, it's going to store a cookie on that device and it's going to remember them. So the user doesn't need to sign in every single time. So this area is simply where you can design your sign-in screen. Currently on our free plan, we can't do really much here. But if and when you upgrade, you can sort of have background images and things like that in terms of conditions links under user agreements. Finally, we've got data. So currently there are no options in our plan. If you do end up upgrading, you'll find that there's an option for extra sync mode. I really recommend this because what it means is your app database is going to synchronize much more frequently and it's just going to give you a more seamless experience. And then you've got your billing. So this is where you can upgrade and manage your plan. So that's the Glide settings panel. And hopefully that all makes sense.
If you found this video helpful and you want to learn more, be sure to check out our full course where we take a deep dive into building apps with Glide, including building a fully functioning to-do list app. The course provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build applications. And if you're new here, be sure to subscribe, leave any questions you have below, and we'll see you in the next video.